12 minutes past the hour right now. Welcome back to the Most News in the Morning. Tea Party-backed candidates have been turning the establishment on its head this election season. They've drawn enthusiastic voters, obviously, to the polls in the primaries. And they've also changed the political landscape in America and have been called out in some cases for some controversial statements. Here's a look. Well, Kathleen Parker joins us now. She's the co-host of Parker Spitzer, the new 8 o'clock show here on CNN, also a columnist for The Washington Post. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So while the Tea Party has really generated a lot of enthusiasm, and they've actually used some of the knocks against them by the, as Sarah Palin calls it, lamestream media to say, see, this is we're real people. They also have been called out for some of those comments. What is it doing to the GOP right now as we move closer and closer to the midterms?
Well, you know, the GOP has always been dull. We can't say that anymore. They've got the most colorful characters in politics. You know, obviously, it's not helpful when you have candidates who are saying rather bizarre things or sort of flashing ignorance about things that they really ought to know about if they're running for public office, particularly the U.S. Senate. But I think there is also this very anti-elite movement out there that is resonating. I mean, some of these candidates, you know, look, when go back to the interview that Sarah Palin had with Katie Couric, and she was at, Katie Couric was asking pretty reasonable questions, frankly. But when Palin couldn't answer them, when she couldn't, for example, think of a Supreme Court decision she didn't agree with, everybody in America was saying, well, I don't know how to answer that question either. But she's got good values and she's one of us. And you start picking on people for not knowing, for not being, you know, Ivy League smart. That's the thing they keep playing. Then, you know, you've got some voters behind you who are just going to come to your defense on the basis of, well, I don't care if she can answer these questions. I don't care if she was a straight A student. And I'm certainly glad she didn't go to an Ivy League college because then her values would be completely off, right? So it hurts them in the general population, but I think when it comes to the GOP base, it actually kind of helps them.
It'll be interesting to see what independents think, though. Karl Rove had some criticisms, and what he said is he likened it to not the Reagan Revolution, where he said this was a well-organized, coherent, ideologically motivated conservative revolution, and he did not say this. He says if you look underneath the surface of the Tea Party movement, you'll find that it is not sophisticated. And that's where it's going to be interesting.
Well,
that's probably an angle in there.
Yeah, well, you get one person in there, they can muck up the works. But I think, you know, this is Sarah Palin being Sarah Palin, and everything she says is essentially for her, I think. No, the Tea Party, look, the Republicans and the Tea Party are people are not so far apart. It's not as though, oh, they're going to come and start pulling strings and everything's got to go their way. I mean, this is what Republicans are wanting to do anyway. They want to cut spending and, you know, freeze taxes, the tax cuts in place. So it's not like they're suddenly on different battlefields. They're essentially speaking with one voice, ultimately. Now, is the GOP through if they don't listen? There is a problem. There is one tension here that is problematic, and that is that if the Tea Party people out yonder being, you know, jacked up by Sarah Palin don't like what's happening, if they don't see results fast enough, they will start attacking Republicans. And that is not helpful. They're going to attack the people who will listen to them. They're not going to attack Democrats. So it could become a problem in terms of launching attacks against the people who are there representing them.
Interesting stuff. Kathleen Parker, great to have you on the show with us this morning. Thanks so much.
Okay, nice to be here.